हेलो एवरीवन, टुडेज टॉपिक इज़ अबाउट सुपीरियर मेसेंट्रिक आर्टरी, स्मॉल इंटेस्टाइन एंड लार्ज इंटेस्टाइन। सुपीरियर मेसेंट्रिक आर्टरी, द सुपीरियर मेसेंट्रिक आर्टरी आर्टरी ऑफ मिडगट, इट सप्लाइज ऑल डेरिवेटिव ऑफ द मिडगट, नेमली लोअर पार्ट ऑफ ड्यूओडेनम बिलो द ओपनिंग ऑफ बाइल डक्ट, जेजुनम, इलियम, अपेंडिक्स, सीकम, असेंडिंग कोलन, राइट टू थर्ड ऑफ ट्रांसवर्स कोलन, लोअर हाफ ऑफ द हेड ऑफ द पेंक्रियास। So in this diagram we can see this is superior mesenteric artery. It arises from abdominal aorta. This is abdominal aorta and it runs towards the right. Origin, course and termination. The superior mesenteric artery arises from the front of abdominal aorta behind the body of pancreas at the level of vertebra L1, 1 cm below the celiac trunk. It runs downward and to the right, forming a curve with its convexity toward the left. At its origin, it lies first behind the body of pancreas and then in front of the uncinate process. Next, it crosses the third part of duodenum, enter the root of mesentery. So, in this diagram, we can see abdominal aorta and superior mesenteric artery and celiac trunk. So, the superior mesenteric artery arises from front of abdominal aorta behind the body of pancreas at the level of vertebra L1. It runs downward and to the right. Relations of the superior mesenteric artery above the root of mesentery. Anterior to this, this is superior mesenteric. Anterior to this superior mesenteric, there is presence of body of pancreas and splenic vein. And posterior to this superior mesenteric, there is presence of aorta, left reddened vein and uncinate process of pancreas and third part of duodenum. So these are some relations above the root of mesentery. Anteriorly head of body of pancreas and splenic vein and posteriorly uncinate process of pancreas, aorta, left renal vein and third part of duodenum. Within the root of mesentery, it crosses the inferior vena cava and the right psoas. Throughout its course, it is accompanied by the superior mesenteric vein. This is superior mesenteric artery. It runs along the superior mesenteric vein in the root of mesentery. It crosses the inferior vena cava and this is inferior vena cava. It crosses the inferior vena cava and the right psoas. Throughout its course, it is accompanied by the superior mesenteric vein, which lies on the right side. The artery is surrounded by superior mesenteric plexus of nerves. Branches. The superior mesenteric artery gives off 5 sets of branches from both its right and left side. Those arising from its right side are inferior pancreaticoduodenal, middle colic, right colic and ileocolic. And those arising from its left side are 12 to 15 jejunum and ileum branches. So branches are some from right side and some from left side. From right side, inferior pancreaticoduodenal, middle colic, right colic and ileocolic. And from the left side, 12 to 15 jejunum and ileal branches. So number one is middle colic artery. Middle colic artery arises from the right side of superior mesenteric artery just below the pancreas. It runs downward, forward in the transverse mesocolon. It divides into a right branch which anastomoses with the right colic artery and a left branch which anastomoses with the left colic artery. Further branches arising from these form arcades and supply the transverse colon. So in this diagram we can see middle colic artery and right colic artery. Next is inferior pancreaticoduodenal artery. Inferior pancreaticoduodenal artery arises from the superior mesenteric artery at the upper border of the third part of duodenum. The artery soon divides into anterior and posterior branches which run in the pancreaticoduodenal groove. Supply the head of the pancreas and the duodenum. So pancreaticoduodenal artery, it supplies head of pancreas and duodenum and ends by anastomosing with the superior pancreaticoduodenal artery. So in this diagram we can see inferior pancreaticoduodenal artery arises from superior mesenteric artery at the upper border of the third part of duodenum. The artery soon divides into anterior and posterior branches which run in the pancreaticoduodenal groove. supply the head of pancreas. Next is right colic artery. Right colic artery arises near the middle of the concavity of the superior mesenteric artery. Right colic artery arises near the middle of concavity of superior mesenteric artery. It passes to the right behind the peritoneum and at the upper part of the ascending colon. It divides into a descending branch which anastomoses with the ileocolic artery and an ascending branch which anastomoses with the middle colic artery. The branches form an arch from the convexity of which smaller branches are distributed to the upper two-thirds of the ascending colon and the right flexure of colon. So in this diagram we can see right colic artery arises near the middle of the concavity of superior mesenteric artery. It passes to the right behind the peritoneum and at the upper part of ascending colon it divides into descending branch which anastomoses with the ileocolic artery and an ascending branch which anastomoses with the middle colic artery. The branches form an arch from the convexity of which smaller branches are distributed to the upper two-thirds of ascending colon and the right flexure of colon. Next artery is ileocolic artery. Ileocolic artery arises from the right side of superior mesenteric artery. It runs downward to the right and divides into superior and inferior branches. The superior branch anastomoses with the right colic artery and the inferior branch anastomoses with the termination of superior mesenteric artery. The inferior branch of ileocolic artery gives off ascending colon branch to the ascending colon, anterior posterior cecal branch to the cecum, appendicular branch which passes behind the ileum and reaches the appendix through its mesentery, ileal branch to the terminal portion of ileum. So in this diagram we can see this is ileocolic vessel and these are posterior ileal vessels, these are anterior cecal artery, posterior cecal and anterior cecal arteries. Next is jejunal and ileal branches. Jejunal and ileal branches are about 12 to 15 in number and arise from the left side of superior mesenteric artery. They run between the two layers of mesentery towards the gut. They anastomosis with one another to form arterial arcade. In the diagram we can see vasa recta and arcades. These are arterial arcade. So jejunal and ileal branches about 12 to 15 in number, arise from left side of superior mesenteric artery. They run between two layers of mesentery. They anastomose with one another to form arterial arcade, which gives off straight branches. These are straight branches. These straight branches called as vasa recta to the gut. These branches supply the jejunum and most of ileum. The terminal part of ileum is supplied by ileocolic artery. So in this diagram we can see these are arcade and these are short vasa recta, these are arcade and these are long vasa recta. On passing from jejunum to ileum, the number of arterial arcade increases. So in this upper diagram there is 1 to 2 arcade and in this lower diagram there is 3 to 4 arcades. On passing from jejunum to ileum, the number of arterial arcade increases from 1 to as many as 5. The vasa recta are longer and less numerous in the jejunum than in ileum. These are distributed alternately to opposite surfaces of gut and the neighboring vessel do not anastomose with one another. Some clinical anatomy. Sudden occlusion of the superior mesenteric artery, vein or both may occur due to embolism or thrombosis. It is usually followed by a rapidly spreading form of intestinal obstruction due to the hemorrhagic infarction of the involved gut. Superior mesenteric artery crosses third part of duodenum. This part of duodenum may get obstructed as it lies between abdominal aorta and superior mesenteric artery. Duodenum behaves like a nut between the two tongues formed by these two arteries. So in this diagram we can see this is duodenum between superior mesenteric artery and abdominal aorta. Next topic is about small intestine. Small intestine features the jejunum and ileum are suspended from the posterior abdominal wall by the mesentery and therefore enjoy considerable mobility. The jejunum constitute the upper 2/5 of the mobile part of small intestine, while the ileum constitute the lower 3/5. The jejunum begins at the duodeno-jejunal flexure. The ileum terminates at the ileocecal junction. The structure and function of the jejunum and ileum correspond to the general description of small intestine. In this diagram, we can see in upper part jejunum and in lower part ileum. Differences between jejunum and ileum. Number one feature is location. Jejunum lies occupy upper and left part of intestinal area, and ileum occupy lower and right part of intestinal area. Walls. In jejunum, walls are thicker, more vascular, and ileum thinner and less vascular. Lumen. In jejunum, wider and empty. In ileum, narrow and loaded. Mesentery. In jejunum, windows present. In ileum, no windows. Jejunum, fat less abundant. Ileum, fat more abundant. Jejunum, arterial arachate 1 or 2. Ileum, arterial arachate 3 to 6. Jejunum vasa recta longer and fewer, ileum vasa recta shorter and numerous. Circular mucosal folds, larger and more closely set in jejunum and smaller and sparse in ileum. Villi, large, thick, leaf-like and more abundant in jejunum, smaller, thinner, finger-like and less abundant in ileum. Pears patches absent in jejunum, present in ileum. Solitary lymphatic follicles, fewer in jejunum and numerous in ileum. Blood supply. The jejunum and ileum supplied by branches from superior mesenteric artery and are drained by corresponding veins. In the diagram we can see superior mesenteric artery. Lymphatic drainage. Lymph from lacteal drain into plexus in the wall of the gut. From there it passes into lymphatic vessels in the mesentery, passing through numerous lymph nodes present in the mesentery and along the superior mesenteric artery. It ultimately drains into nodes present in front of aorta at the origin of superior mesenteric artery. Nerve supply. Sympathetic nerves are from T9, T11 segment and parasympathetic from vagus. Meckel's diverticulum, diverticulum ilii. Meckel's diverticulum is the persistent proximal part of vitellointestinal duct which is present in the embryo and which normally disappears during the 6th week of intrauterine life. Some points of interest about it as follows. It occurs in 2% subjects. Usually it is 2 inches or 5 cm long. It is situated about 2 feet or 60 cm proximal to ileocecal wall, attached to antimesenteric border of the ileum. Its caliber is equal to that of the ileum. Its apex may be free or may be attached to the umbilicus, to the mesentery or to any other abdominal structure by a fibrous band. This is Meckel's diverticulum. It is persistent proximal part of vitellointestinal duct which is present in the embryo and which normally disappears during the 6th week of intrauterine life. It occurs in 2% subject. It is 2 inches long. It is situated about 2 feet proximal to ileocecal valve. Some applied aspect of Meckel's diverticulum. Meckel's diverticulum may cause intestinal obstruction. Occasionally, it may have small regions of gastric mucosa. Acute inflammation of the diverticulum may produce symptoms that resemble those of appendicitis. It may be involved in other diseases similar to those of the intestine. Next topic is about large intestine. Extends from ileocecal junction to anus. It is about 1.5 meter long and it divided into cecum, ascending colon, right colic flexure, transverse colon, rectum and anal canal. So in this diagram we can see this is cecum, then ascending colon, right colic flexure, transverse colon, rectum and anal canal. In the angle between cecum and the terminal part of ileum there is presence of a narrow diverticulum called वर्मी फॉर्म अपेंडिक्स। द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ द लार्ज इंटेस्टाइन इज अडेप्टेड फॉर स्टोरेज ऑफ मैटर रीचिंग इट फ्रॉम द स्मॉल इंटेस्टाइन एंड फॉर एब्जॉर्प्शन ऑफ फ्लूइड एंड सॉल्यूट्स फ्रॉम इट। द एपिथीलियम इज एब्जॉर्प्टिव बट विलाई आर एब्सेंट। एडिक्वेट लुब्रिकेशन फॉर पैसेज ऑफ इट्स कंटेंट इज प्रोवाइडेड बाई न्यूमरस गॉबलेट सेल्स स्कैटर्ड इन द क्रिप्ट्स एज वेल एज ऑन द सर्फेस ऑफ म्यूकस मेम्ब्रेन। द प्रेजेंस ऑफ न्यूमरस सोलिटरी लिम्फेटिक फॉलिकल्स प्रोवाइड प्रोटेक्शन अगेंस्ट बैक्टीरिया प्रेजेंट इन ल्यूमन ऑफ द इंटेस्टाइन। द लार्ज इंटेस्टाइन इज वाइडर इन कैलिवर देन द स्मॉल इंटेस्टाइन। द कैलिवर इज ग्रेटेस्ट at its commencement and gradually diminishes towards the rectum where it is dilated to form the rectal ampulla just above the anal canal. The greater part of large intestine is fixed except for the appendix, transverse colon and segment colon. The longitudinal muscle coat forms only a thin layer in this part of gut. The greater part of it forms three ribbon-like bands called the tenia coli. Proximally, the tenia converge at the base of appendix and distally, they spread out on the terminal part of sigmoid colon to become continuous with the longitudinal muscle coat of the rectum. In the cecum, the ascending colon, the descending colon and sigmoid colon, the position of tenia are anterior or tenia libera, posterior medial or tenia mesocolica and posterior lateral or tenia omentalis. But in the transverse colon, the corresponding position of tenia are inferior, posterior and superior. One tenia, tenia libera, is placed anteriorly in the cecum, ascending, descending and sigmoid colon, but is placed inferiorly in transverse colon. This is tenia omentalis, tenia libera and tenia mesocolica. The muscle coat, longitudinal muscle coat, forms only a thin layer. The greater part of it forms three ribbon-like band called the tenia coli. The cecum, ascending colon, descending colon and sigmoid colon. In the cecum, ascending colon, descending colon and sigmoid colon, the tenia are anterior, posteromedial and posterolateral. But in transverse colon, position of tenia are inferior, posterior and superior. Posterior, inferior and superior. Tenia libera lies anteriorly. Tenia mesocolica, posteromedial, tenia omentalis, posterolateral. Second tenia, tenia mesocolica, is present on the posteromedial surface of cecum, ascending, descending and sigmoid colon, but is placed posteriorly on transverse colon at the site of attachment of transverse mesocolon. Third tenia, tenia omentalis, is situated posteriorly in cecum, ascending, descending and transverse colon, but is situated on the anterosuperior surface of transverse colon. Since the tenia are shorter than the circular muscle coat, the colon is puckered and sacculated. Small bags of peritoneum filled with fat are called the appendices. Epiploike are scattered over the surface of large intestine, except for the appendix, the cecum and the rectum. These are most numerous on the sides of sigmoid colon and on the posterior surface of the transverse colon. Differences between the small intestine and the large intestine. Number one feature is appendices epiploike, present in large intestine, absent in small intestine. Tenia coli, present in large intestine, absent in small intestine. Sacculations, present in large intestine, absent in small intestine. Disability and diameter, more disable and more diameter in large intestine, less disable, distensibility and less diameter. Fixity, greater part is fixed, greater part is freely mobile in small intestine. विलाई, एबसेंट इन लार्ज इंटेस्टाइन, प्रेजेंट इन स्मॉल इंटेस्टाइन, ट्रांसफर्स म्यूकोजल फोल्ड, परमानेंट इन स्मॉल इंटेस्टाइन, ओब्लिटरेटेड विद लॉन्जिट्यूडिनल मसल कोड, रिलैक्स इन लार्ज इंटेस्टाइन, पेयर्स पैचेस, एबसेंट इन लार्ज इंटेस्टाइन, प्रेजेंट इन इलियम. लार्ज इंटेस्टाइन इज कॉमन साइट फॉर एंटमीबा, डिसेंट्री एंड कार्सिनोमा. स्मॉल इंटेस्टाइन कॉमन साइट फॉर इंटेस्टाइनल वर्म्स, टाइफॉइड, ट्यूबरकुलोसिस. इफेक्ट ऑफ इन्फेक्शन एंड इरिटेशन, डायरिया इन स्मॉल इंटेस्टाइन, डिसेंट्री इन लार्ज इंटेस्टाइन. द ब्लड सप्लाई टू द कोलन इज डिराइव्ड फ्रॉम मार्जिनल आर्टरी. इट इज फॉर्म्ड बाय कोलिक ब्रांचेस ऑफ सुपीरियर इन्फीरियर मेसेंट्रिक आर्टरी. टर्मिनल ब्रांचेस फ्रॉम द मार्जिनल आर्टरी आर डिस्ट्रीब्यूटेड टू द इंटेस्टाइन एज लॉन्ग एंड शॉर्ट वेसल, वासा लॉन्गा एंड वासा ब्रेविया. द लॉन्ग आर्टरी डिवाइड इन टू एंटीरियर पोस्टीरियर ब्रांचेस क्लोज टू द मेसोकोलिक टीनिया टू पास बिटवीन द सीरस एंड मस्कुलर कोट एंड रीचेस द ए मेसोकोलिक टीनिया. दे ग्रेजुअली पियर्स द मसल कोट एंड रीच द सबम्यूकोसा. द एनास्टोमोसिस बिटवीन द टू ए मेसोकोलिक टीनिया इज एक्सट्रीमली पुअर. सो लॉन्जिट्यूडनल इंसिजन शुड बी मेड अलॉन्ग दिस लाइन. Short branches arise either from the marginal artery or from the long branches, and the majority of them at once sink into the bowel wall at the mesocolic border. The short and long branches together thus provide the mesocolic region of the wall with abundant blood supply. It is only the amesocolic region which has scanty blood supply. So in this diagram we can see marginal artery of it is marginal artery. It is formed by colic branches of superior and inferior mesenteric artery. This is marginal artery. It is formed by colic branches of superior mesenteric artery. This is superior mesenteric artery and this is inferior mesenteric artery. This is left colic sigmoid artery. Superior rectal. Subserous coat of long branches is intimately related to appendices apoploica, to which they contribute branches. During removal of these appendages, care must be taken not to pull on them in order to avoid traction on the subjacent vessel. Bowel wall is weakened where it is pierced by vessels and at the site of attachment of appendices apoploica. Mucosa may herniate in these situations, causing diverticulosis with associated dangers of diverticulitis, fibrosis, and stricture. Lymph from the large intestine passes through four sets of lymph nodes. Apicoloic lymph nodes lying on the wall of the gut. Paracolic nodes on the medial side of ascending and descending colon and near the mesocolic border of the transverse and sigmoid colon. Intermediate nodes on the main branches of the vessels. Terminal nodes on the superior inferior mesenteric vessels. In carcinoma of the colon, the related paracolic and intermediate lymph nodes have to be removed. Their removal is possible only after the ligature of the main branch of the superior or inferior mesenteric artery along with the involved lymph nodes. It is necessary therefore to remove a larger segment of bowel than in is actually required by the extent of the disease in order to avoid gangrene as a result of interference with the blood supply. It is always wise to remove the whole portion of bowel supplied by ligated vessel. The nerve supply of large intestine bearing the lower half of the anal canal is both sympathetic and parasympathetic. The midgut territory receives its sympathetic supply from the celiac and superior mesenteric ganglia and its parasympathetic supply from the vagus. Both types of nerves are distributed to the gut through the superior mesenteric plexus. The hindgut territory receives its sympathetic supply from the lumbar sympathetic chain L1 L2 and its parasympathetic supply from the pelvic splenic nerve nervi irrigans, both via the superior hypogastria and inferior mesenteric plexus. Some parasympathetic fibers reach the colon along the posterior abdominal wall. The ultimate distribution of nerves in the gut is similar to that in the wall of the small intestine. The parasympathetic nerves are motor to the large intestine and inhibitory to the internal anal sphincter. The sympathetic nerves are largely vasomotor but also motor to the internal anal sphincter and inhibitory to colon. Pain impulses from the gut up to the descending colon travel through the sympathetic nerves and from the sigmoid colon and rectum through the pelvic splanchnic nerves. Functions of colon. Number 1. Lubrication of feces by mucus, absorption of water, salt and other solutes, bacteria flora of colon, synthesis vitamin B, mucoid secretion of colon is rich in antibodies of immunoglobulin A group which protect it from invasion by microorganisms. The microvilli of subcolumnar cells serve a sensory function. Clinical anatomy. Large intestine can be directly viewed by a procedure called colonoscopy. Diverticulum is a small evagination of mucous membrane of colon at the entry point of arteries. Its inflammation is called diverticulitis. So this is all about superior mesenteric artery, small intestine and large intestine.